This is the Alipur Zoo in Kolkata. It's just like all other zoological parks in India. It is home to a lot of fascinating species of birds and animals. But one thing is special about it, and that is the Indian one-horned rhinoceros. You won't find them in many zoos in India, as they are almost extinct now. The worst part is that even in the Alipur Zoo, the number of these rhinos is gradually decreasing.
Now, we might wonder, what is so fascinating about rhinoceros? They are so ugly and prehistoric. But have you ever looked at them closely? They are unique and docile creatures. But then the question arises, why do they have a tendency to attack humans?
Rhinos attack humans for a reason. We are the reason itself, the entire human species.
For ages, mass deforestation caused by us has led to the loss of forests and jungles in our country.
Trade in rhino horns is immensely profitable, as they are prized items used as a status symbol or as exhibition pieces. They are also used in traditional Chinese medicine, leading to large-scale poaching, which has assumed alarming proportions in recent times. The outcome of the reduction of forests has ended in trapping the rhinos in cages. The Indian one-horned rhinoceros breed is now marked in the IUCN Red List as a part of the critically endangered species.
The rhinos as a symbol are used all around us, from the seals of Mohenjo-daro to present pop culture.
Yes, it's in the logo of a tire company.
Even WWE wrestling.
Or as Pokemons, like Rhydon and its evolved form Rhyhorn.
Hey, do you know, rhinos were even the magnificent artist Salvador Dali's favorite animal. The relationship between Salvador Dali and rhinos was not only evident in his extraordinary sculptures and paintings, but was also depicted in famous filmmaker Woody Allen's film Midnight in Paris.
The rhinoceros? I haven't really thought about it.
I paint the rhinoceros. I paint you. See, your sad eyes and big lips melting over the hot sand with one tear. Yes, and in your tear, another face. The Christ face. Yes, and the rhinoceros.
After a decade or so, you will see us in the museums and galleries. The show of our body parts and horns may seem fascinating to you, but we will no longer be living and moving, and you can never see us again alive.